What are accelerators? Describe construction and working of cyclotron. Accelerators are the devices or machines with the help of which we can increase the velocity of a projectile, or we can increase the energy of the particles, as energy E is equals to half mv square, where m is the mass of the projectile and v is the velocity. So as velocity v increases, energy E increases. Accelerators are of two types: electrostatic accelerator and cyclic accelerators. And also cyclic accelerators are of again two types: linear cyclic accelerator or cyclotron. So let's discuss about electrostatic accelerator. It is a long vacuum tube which is surrounded by permanent magnets. These permanent magnets, they generate electrostatic field across the tube. When a charged particle enters the tube, it feels the attractive force because of the electrostatic attraction from the magnetic field. And that's why particle gets accelerated. This whole process increases the velocity of the particle and as well energy of the particle. This device can increase the energy of the particle to a certain limit only. Next comes linear cyclic accelerator or Linac. Linac is again a long vacuum tube which is having number of alternate electrodes, and these electrodes are connected with an oscillator. This oscillator generates the electrostatic force between the electrodes. The charges on these electrodes are fluctuating in a cyclic manner with the help of this oscillator. So when a charged particle enters in the tube, it is attracted towards the first plane because of the electrostatic attraction. When it reaches the first plate, the polarity of the plates is changed and the particle is now attracted towards the next plate. In this way, the process goes on continuing and the particle feels more and more attraction from the neighboring plates. And that's why the velocity of the particle goes on increasing as it crosses each and every plate. And finally, the energy of the particle is also increases multiple times. Linac can increase the energy of the particle to a significant extent. But the biggest problem in the Linac is placing large number of electrodes in a long tube. Next is cyclotron. Lorentz and Livingston developed a method that avoids the limitation of Linac. The instrument used is known as Magnetic Resonance Accelerator or cyclotron. The main principle is, when a charged particle or projectile is placed under the magnetic field, it starts revolving in a circular path. The velocity of the particle can be increased by the application of a high frequency oscillator in the direction of particle's motion. The cyclotron consists of two flat semicircular shaped metal boxes called dees. These hollow boxes are slightly separated from each other as shown in the figure. A source of projectile is placed at the midpoint of the gap between two dees. The two dees are connected with two terminals of high frequency oscillator so that they act as the electrodes. The dees are enclosed in a large insulated metal box. Whole metal box is placed between two poles of strong magnets which provide magnetic field perpendicular to the plane of the dee. Generally, when any charged particle is placed under the strong magnetic field, it starts revolving in a circular path as per the right hand thumb rule. But the motion of this particle is uniform. That means it is revolving with a constant velocity. So energy is also constant. But now, when the oscillating frequency is applied across the two dees, both dees acquire opposite charges and the particle gets attracted towards the opposite charge. So this increases its velocity as well as energy. But as soon as the particle reaches to that d, the polarity of the d's are reversed with the help of oscillator. And now the particle moves in the backward direction in a circular motion. And now again there will be attraction between the charged particle and the oppositely charged d. So again the velocity of the particle increases as well as energy increases. So similarly, every time when particle is moving from one D to other D, the polarity of the D is changed. And due to this oscillation, the particle gains more and more velocity as well as more and more energy. If you like this video, please click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel. And now you can also have lecture notes from chepecmedia.co.nf.